Bellbrook High School, welcome. You are cordially invited to watch the first and probably only edition of Bellbrook Bachelor. I'm your host, Cooper Shank, and here is your eligible homecoming bachelor, Jacob Dryden. In this series, we will have a multitude of women competing for Dryden's love for homecoming. Let's meet the contestants. So, Elizabeth, describe to me your perfect date.
My perfect date would be going to Chuck E. Cheese and getting in the ticket blaster. It's just such a good time in there. And then riding the clock. It's like this little thing, you like sit on it, but it'd have to be with a guy. Sit on it, and you just like ride it around. It's a lot of fun.
Very interesting. Sorry, could you take your shoes off out of respect, please?
Yes?
Okay, I'm sorry, it's just, I wasn't paying attention because your shoes were on. Anyways, so, if you could be any animal, what would it be and why? Any animal at all?
I would be a platypus.
Why that?
Because I love Phineas and Ferb and I want to be on the TV show.
Oh, gotcha. Mm-hmm. All right, well, thank you for your time. Leave. Nope, don't. Just stand up. Okay. So, Jenny, describe to me your perfect date.
My perfect date would probably have to be going to see Capacity, my favorite band.
Really, what's so great about Capacity?
Is their music, it really speaks to me, and I really think it would speak to many other Americans.
What, like, how does it speak to you, really?
Well, the singers, they say words.
Oh.
And they're speaking to me.
That actually makes a lot of sense. I never thought about it that way. So, if you could be any animal, what would it be and why?
I'd probably have to be a Capacitysaurus, which is actually an extinct dinosaur that was once indigenous to Africa. And they really thrived on listening to Capacity's music because it's so full of passion and they feed on passion. So.
Oh, as nourishment?
Yes, oh. As nourishment.
Interesting. Well, thank you for your time, Jimmy. So, Colleen, describe to me your perfect day.
Well, I'd have to say my perfect day would be, first of all, go to McDonald's. We're gonna order off the dollar menu. So we save money for our wedding later on. And then we're gonna go to Myers, put a quarter in the ring machine so we get our wedding rings for our wedding. And then, yeah.
That's cute.
I know.
Oh, okay, well.
I've planned it since I was like 2.
It's a lot of planning.
Oh my God, you have no idea. No idea.
All right, well, if you could be any animal, what would it be and why?
I would have to be a dog, because a dog is a man's best friend, and Jake, I want to be your best friend.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you, Colleen.
Thank you so much.
Haley, describe to me your perfect date.
My idea of a perfect date would be probably just going to his house and talking with his parents for a couple of hours. And then just walking around the neighborhood and looking at different kinds of cats.
Oh, really? You're a cat person?
I am.
Okay, well, so what animal would you be and why?
I would be a sea sponge because I would just want to absorb Jake's love.
Good answer.
Thank you.
Is cat in second place? Okay. Makes sense. All right, well, thank you for your time.
No problem.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Erica.
Yes.
Describe to me your perfect date.
My perfect date?
Mm-hmm.
Well, he would come over to my house, or his house, it doesn't really matter. And we would watch Titanic, because I think a real man can show a sensitive side, and I really love that in a man.
Okay. So you want him to cry?
Well, that's kind of pushing it. I mean, if he really wants to, then I guess he can, but then that kind of shows his wimpy side, not sensitive.
Okay. I see. So, if you could be any animal, what would it be and why?
Well, I'd probably be a teddy bear because they're just so warm and cuddly.
Are you aware that those aren't real animals?
I think.
Are you, Erica?
Yes.
Okay, that's fine. That's all I need to know.
Okay.
Good job.
Okay, bye.
Leave. So, Darby, describe to me your perfect day.
perfect date? Well, I would take him to where I want to go, and he would pay, because man gotta have money. Amen.
I see. Gotta be rich. I like that, gold digger. Alright, so, if you could be any animal, what would it be?
I'd want to be a cat.
Why is that?
Because I like to be like, wow.
That's cute. Alright, I'm gonna be a cat. So, Sydney.
Yeah.
What's your perfect date? Okay, well, do you like animals? Animals.
What?
Animals.
What?
They're animals. Like a cat, dog, mouse, rat.
I'm allergic to animals. I can't do that.
Ginny, I called you here because I have to tell you something very important. Like, super serious, top secret. Oh, I think you can do better.
Ginny, is it true you have a boyfriend you're just not here to promote your band? I've decided this isn't gonna work. You're off the show.
The world is spinning too fast. I'm fine that Nike shoes to keep myself tethered to the days I tried to lose. My mama said to slow down, you must make your own shoes. Stop dancing to the music. I've got gorillas in a happy mood. Keep my groove on. Watching a fake betrayal, caught up in the conflict between his brain and his tail. And if time's elimination, then we got nothing to lose. Please repeat the message, it's the music that we choose. Keep on our groove on.
Eating an entire meatball, like swallowing without chewing. And then my cousin Ray Ray comes up, and he's like, dude, that was my meatball. I'm like, hey, Ray! Oh, due to injuries sustained on the set, Haley Mason has been eliminated.
Challenge 2, eating grapes.
Yeah, so that's why Jumper 2 would be the best movie of 2011. Like, revenge.
Hello. Well, I have to be honest with you, Darby. I'm afraid of cats. And that grape challenge reminded me a little too much of a cat. And your personality is just a little too feline for my taste, so.
Oh, really?
Challenge 3, arm wrestling.
in your sand.
Gentlemen, we have had contest after contest after contest to see who was going to win Jake Dryden's love. Let's see what he has to say.
All right, ladies, it's been a nice road, and I'm hoping we can all still be friends after this. And I've been going back and forth all day, and I still don't know, you know, where to go for you, a freshman and senior, and I just can't decide. So I choose Chris.